What's up, guys? How are you? Welcome into the Sunday morning edition of the Daily Juice Podcast. My name is Matt Perrault here on BettingPros.com. We're always being brought to you by BetMGM, and I am back. We are back on YouTube. We are back in the home studio, and we are back on my birthday. More in just 1 second on that. We go 1-1 last night. I don't know if you guys have come down or not after that incredible shot by Suggs to win the national semifinal. If you were on UCLA Moneyline, that was a bad beat, man. That's a prayer shot. Double overtime should have happened. Crusher for UCLA. I was at a UCLA bar before I flew out, and we watched the Baylor game with a bunch of UCLA people, but they were waiting on the big game, obviously, for Gonzaga. And as I said last night on the podcast, man, I mean, betting plus 14 was just on principle. I didn't do it, but I mean, that against probably any other team, I probably would have done it. It's just that they had been winning so consistently. First time all year, they didn't win by double digits. And it goes to overtime, and they get a banked three from three-quarter or whatever it was, you know, 10 feet behind the three-point line. I don't know if that's a great shot or just pure luck. I don't know what to make of that. But regardless, it went. And now we get Baylor versus Gonzaga in the national championship game. We'll have multiple bets and plays on that. Reminder on the live stream, I had it wrong yesterday. Okay, the live stream is 7:30 Eastern on Monday on our YouTube channel, 4:30 Pacific time. So I was all crossed up and I was all messed up. I was on beach time. So 7:30 on Monday tomorrow night for the live stream. We'll break down the natty, picks, plays, parlays, props, all sorts of good stuff to give you guys coming up for the national championship game off our YouTube channel. For betting pros coming up on Monday, but 1-1 yesterday because Gonzaga goes ahead and gets themselves another first half cover. More on that in just 1 second. And well, today is my birthday. So since today is my birthday, if you are a longtime listener of Pushing the Odds, my radio programs, you will recognize this little ditty that I'm going to actually play on my phone. I'm going to hold it up here, give you a little musical interlude. I'm feeling good, got off the plane, my nose is sunburned, beach time, but let's talk about my guy's cracker for a second. If you're watching on YouTube, that looked absolutely insane. I'm holding my phone up to the mic as we're doing this. But that song, I have played that song on every radio show I have done since I was, I don't know, 20 or so when that album came out by Cracker. If you are a Camper Van Beethoven fan, you know Cracker. They're great. They're a phenomenal band, and I have been a big fan my whole life, and I've played that song, Happy Birthday to Me, because today I turned 44. So here's what I'm doing today for the podcast. I have four sports that we're making bets on coming up today. One of those will be the return of NBA player props in the Discord channel. So I will have that for you guys. We'll come roaring back to life on the Discord channel. If you're watching on YouTube, go ahead and click below. You guys can get into the Discord channel, and I'll have two player props. Our record is 27-7 still? Hold on, let me double check. Let me see what our record is officially. The official record of the Daily Juice props. I can pull these up. You guys can always search this on Betting Pros too, my record on things. But the official record for player props is 22-7. All right, we're 22-7. We're up 3.2 units, 75%. 75%. So we're coming back with that, okay? Man, I'll tell you what. I actually thought about betting NASCAR today. I thought about betting golf today. I thought about doing all sorts of kind of wacko things because I was like, you know what? It's my birthday. Why not? Let's do some funky wacko stuff. And then I was like, there's nothing really that I want to jump up and down with here with NASCAR that I want to go ahead and bet on. And I don't even think there's even a race today. I don't know. But then there's golf. And I thought about, okay, what about get real exotic? Let's bet golf. And then I was like, and the Masters is next week. I'm not betting. I'm not doing that. So here's what I've got. One hockey, one baseball, one college basketball, and the NBA player props. four sports, four bets. Really, it's five bets, but four sports on April the 4th, and I turned 44. I'm an alliteration guy, all right? I am a person, I enjoy numbers, and on 4-4, turning 44, I don't know, let's have some fun. Let's do some different things. I may fall on my face, but I don't really care. It's four bets coming up. So one of the sports, there'll be two bets coming up here for player props for the NBA in the Discord channel. That's one. Number two is the first bet coming up on Monday. And I don't need to go really heavily into this. This should be pretty self-explanatory. The Gonzaga Zags in the first half have been a covering machine for us here in the tournament. Against Baylor, I don't see any difference. I don't see any reason why the total 76 first half total won't get hit pretty easily. And I thought 69 was going to be a problem. About 14 minutes to play in the first half, I think we had scored like 21 points between UCLA and Gonzaga. I didn't think we were going to get 36, 38 points, whatever it was, out of UCLA in the first half, but I took it because we walked to the over 69. That was easy. The total is 76 for the first half over here. I don't care. It's a national championship game. Gonzaga is the number one team first half. Baylor's very good as well first half. Both teams are going to run. Both teams are going to score. The total in this game is 160. It's stupid high. First half over, Gonzaga and Baylor. First half over, 76. I bet it tonight. Minus 110. Take it. Run with it. Let's just keep that rolling here. I love the fact that that number was out really, really early. Right when the game came out, the books popped up their numbers, and I was like, thank you. That is absolutely phenomenal to do that. 76, you know, it's funny because the total was 160. 76, I thought they might juice this up a little bit to first half total points to like 81, 82, somewhere in that range. They're going at 76. Gonzaga has hit that the last two times we bet that for us. It's been very good in the tournament. We're going through it again here, 76. You could say, oh, it's the national championship game. Maybe they slowed down a little bit. Fine. Not how the Zags play, okay? The Zags aren't great defensively. They're going to run and shoot threes. And I'll have a bunch of stuff going, but college basketball bet, first half over, Gonzaga, 76 points. We're going over, minus 110. All right, one baseball play. My Red Sox are 0-2, and I want to bet the Red Sox today, but I'm not going to make you guys do that. I'm going to bet the Red Sox. I'm going to watch the Red Sox. It's my birthday. I'm going to order some wings. I'm a glutton for punishment. My bet for the Red Sox to win more than 79 games is already looking like crap. I'm really mad about that. They're 0-2. But the other team that's 0-2 that's shocking me, the Atlanta Braves. They've lost the first two games on the road to the Philadelphia Phillies. And Zach Wheeler was outstanding yesterday. 10 Ks, one hit, no walks. I mean, the Braves had no answer. They got shut out, right? So now, here come the Braves going deep. Ian Anderson is a guy, sophomore year last year, 1.95 ERA, was great as a rookie year. Anderson was just a stud, three-pitch pitcher. Zach Eflin going on their side, not a bad pitcher by any means, but you get shut out, and you're 0-2, and you haven't won yet, and now the game's on ESPN, it's on national TV. Look, I'm not getting too crazy here. In Vegas, the Braves are minus 115 on the money line. I'm going Freddie Freeman. I'm going, to get a W here and not get swept in the first series of the year against a team in the Phillies that really you're going to be battling with all year long. Better starting pitcher, angry team. I just think, my gosh, you roll out two really good starting pitchers and you lose both games. It's like, whoa. I thought about going first five here. That was, maybe that's something you want to eyeball a little bit is first five with these teams, but I kind of want the ability to get in that Philadelphia Phillies bullpen. So I like the fact that Phillies have a bad bullpen, and I want to roll with that. I don't want to totally overemphasize that. So there's actually, across, you can find anywhere from like 125, 130. I got 115 at Circa. So you got 115, the Braves on the money line here up against the Philadelphia Phillies. Better starting pitcher, going with that. All right. Another number in Vegas, which I found to be kind of interesting, that's a little bit higher than the rest of the country, and maybe this is something that I'm not seeing right, but let's talk the one hockey bet today, Toronto at Calgary. So both teams having really good goaltending, and both teams offensively have been kind of eh. So the Maple Leafs are right now, the under is 5-1 over the last six games involving the Maple Leafs. For Calgary, the under is 5-1-1 over their last seven games overall. So the number in Vegas I got was 6. 6 minus 120. It's 5.5 minus 115 at most books at the time of taping right now. And this is, again, where you've got two teams, decent goaltending. And, I mean, the Maple Leafs haven't played great. I don't know if it really matters, but they're 1-9 over the last 10 games on Sunday. It's not really, I don't really care too much about that. But the Maple Leafs are 4-1 over the last five meetings in Calgary. So you might go, well, Calgary's due to protect the home ice here. But I got 6. And I told you, I like betting totals when I can get a 6 because I think there's a good chance we can push. So I got an under. I think given the numbers with both teams, 5-1 over the last six overall for Toronto, and 6-1 over the last seven games as an underdog for Calgary, 5-1-1 overall over the last seven games here for the Calgary Flames. Both teams not scoring a ton, both teams playing good defense, and I think we're going to see another under here between Toronto and Calgary. Under six goals between Toronto and Calgary at minus 120, all right? So four sports, NBA, Major League Baseball, college basketball, NHL, okay? Three bets that I just gave you. Two bets in one sport, the player props, will come before we see tip-off on Sunday. Now, there is a big NBA slate of games coming up. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 games, okay? If there aren't any player props that I like, I'm going to tell you this right now. I'm personally already on New Orleans, -4.5 against Houston, but I don't want to give that out as an official play because I don't know who's playing in this game. The list of players who are questionable for this game are bad. Zion's questionable, Brandon Ingram's questionable, Lonzo Ball could be out as well, but John Wall is out as well for the Houston Rockets. The Rockets are bad, okay? They're not a good team. The Pelicans, if they're going to make the postseason, they got to stop this slide. They've lost two games in a row. They're 21-27. They're six games back of Dallas. Not good, okay? It's not good right now with what's going on in New Orleans. So they got to win this game on the road against a bad Rockets team. Not going to give it out officially until I find out what's happening with the lineup. So if everyone's playing, if Zion's playing, and Lonzo Ball's playing, and everyone's playing, then fine, I may come back and say, all right, I'm going to say the 4.5 is an official play. But I'm just laying the 4.5 personally. So that's the only real NBA game that I like, but I'm not playing that officially. So if you want something extra, jump on that. I'm not doing that officially unless I hate all the player props, but we'll see what the player props are coming up tomorrow. So those are the props. So NBA is going to be a player prop, okay? Braves, money line, minus 115. Gonzaga, first half, over 76, minus 110. And Toronto and Calgary under six goals at minus 120. Four plays on April the 4th on my 44th birthday. How about that? It's good to be back. It's good to be home. Good to be here with you guys. Thanks for all the nice messages already on my birthday. That was really cool. I appreciate you guys doing that, sending me messages. If I didn't write you back, I apologize. It's been kind of a crazy traveling with a six-year-old. It's always really kind of, you know, it is what it is. And it's been, I'll sleep well tonight. How about that? It's nice to be home. It was a really, really fun trip. If you guys follow me on social media, you can see a bunch of pictures. If you like my family, you can go look at my pictures on Instagram at SportsTalkMatt, or Twitter's got a couple of them at SportsTalkMatt, but mostly it's on Instagram. Just pictures of the trip and what we did and where we went and whatnot. So, you know, if you care about that type of stuff, you can follow me on Instagram. But Twitter really is where you're going to get the most of the messages. So make sure you're in the Discord channel, though. That's the important place to be for the player props that I will be dropping with our 75% clip, our documented 22-7 record that we've been on, which is pretty darn good. Having a lot of fun doing that, and we're going to go right back to it here with a chance to make some more money, hopefully, here today on the Sunday. Happy Easter, everybody, by the way. I kind of got a little, like, lost on it. It's, you know, it's Easter right now, so I don't know if you guys, how you feel about gambling on Easter. I don't really care, but, you know, it's Easter, so it's my birthday. There's your cover, right? It's not Easter. It's Matt's birthday. You got to bet on Matt's birthday. You got to do that, right? So, again, our four plays. Braves money line, first half Gonzaga over 76, Toronto-Calgary under six goals, and NBA player props to come later today on the Discord channel. My name is Matt Perrault. You can follow me on Twitter, at SportsTalkMatt, every single morning on YouTube and on wherever you get your podcasts. It's the Daily Juice Podcast, just like the shirt says, the Daily Juice Podcast here on BettingPros.com, brought to you by BetMGM.